Hi everyone, in this video I'll be giving you a quick overview of how to conduct a literature search in the library database Embase. Embase is a nice complement to searching PubMed Medline because it covers Medline as well, but it also has some more journals with a European focus, so it can give you some additional articles and make sure you're not limiting yourself to just the US. So similar to accessing our other resources, you want to start on the medical library homepage and then go to library resources. Once you're on our library resources page, you can type Embase into the search box and click apply. You'll now see the link to click to open Embase. Remember, if you're off campus, you'll likely be prompted to sign in via Open Athens. Make sure to click Florida Atlantic University and then sign in with your FAU NetID and password. I've already done this, so you can see now I was able to open Embase and I'm connected via FAU. I think at some point I also even created an account with Embase so it recognized my account in case I wanted to save any information or set up any alerts. If you've watched the video I made about how to search PubMed, it's a similar idea, except that Embase won't do that automatic mapping behind the scenes for you. But what it will do is it will make suggestions as you type. So I'm going to use the same search example that I showed in the PubMed video to show you the similarities and differences between PubMed and Embase. And if you remember from that example, the clinical scenario was you had a patient with systemic lupus erythematosus. They were interested in using turmeric instead of Plaquenil as an intervention to help them with joint pain. So our PICO elements were those four pieces. So I'm going to type them into the boxes here and show you how it can make suggestions for the best keywords to use. And another thing I like about Embase is it can actually tell you before you search how many results you're going to get. So you know if you're going to get zero results before you even try a search. So in the first search box, I'm going to start typing systemic lupus erythematosus. And as I mentioned, it will suggest to you the best keyword for your search, although it's a computer, so ask yourself if it's really the best keyword. It might be recommending something that you don't want. And it's showing that if I searched all of Embase for this term, there would be 106,252 results. Now, I want to narrow this down. I don't want everything about systemic lupus erythematosus, so I'm going to add another keyword. They try to be helpful and suggest that you could search by journal name, an author first name, but we want to stick to our PICO quick search keywords here, so I'm going to change it to quick search. The other really important thing we wanted to look at was turmeric, because we were trying to consider if turmeric would be a good intervention for joint pain. And you can see it gives you several options. If you wanted turmeric, just turmeric, or if you wanted turmeric yellow, they actually say to use this word instead. I'm going to stick with turmeric. Similarly, I can change quick search and then joint pain. And again, it says instead of joint pain, use this word. Oh, and what I wanted to show you is every time I'm adding another portion of my PICO, I'm getting less and less results. So now if I search these three words together, I'm only going to have two results left. And if I add my last part of my PICO, which was Plaquenil, they say instead use hydroxychloroquine sulfate, I would have zero results left. So that's similar to what we talked about in PubMed, is if you try to use all four elements of your PICO, if it's a subject that not a lot of people are researching or writing about, you might have zero results back. So instead, I could search just the first two terms together. Or let's say I wanted to take turmeric out for now. I'll delete this. I'd have 29 results for systemic lupus erythematosus, joint pain, and Plaquenil. I was really interested though in turmeric, so I'm going to add that back in. And that's the search that I showed you in PubMed. So I want to show you how it would differ in Embase. Delete this one. So I'm going to have 27 results if I search for systemic lupus erythematosus and turmeric. In PubMed, I think I had 10, results maybe. So I'm actually getting more if I search in Embase than just searching in PubMed. And now you can see these are the 27 search results that I have. On the left, similar to our other resources, you can narrow down what you're finding. With only 27 results, I'm not sure how much more specific I would want to go, but it is interesting. It can tell you the focus of the gender within the studies, or perhaps the age. I'll let you look through these on your own. I won't spend time going over them in the video. And you can always ask the medical librarians for help if you have questions about any of them. What I do want to show, which I think can be very enlightening and helpful, is the sources. Because Embase has its own journals, but it also includes all the results from Medline. So you might see some duplicates of what you searched when you searched PubMed. PubMed includes some of its own journals and the Medline results as well. So you'll have some overlap, just like it's showing you this Venn diagram here. Three of your results are coming from Medline, so you probably already saw those if you searched in PubMed Medline. But you have 11 that are specific only to Embase. And as you're looking through the results, it will tell you this first one is an Embase and Medline, but the second one is only an Embase, so it's probably one you haven't seen yet. Okay. If you have any questions about that, please feel free to ask us. I know that can be a little bit confusing. Medline is included in a lot of different databases, so you'll see some repeats, but you'll also see some new articles. Similar to our other databases, if it says free full text, you can click on that link and it can sometimes connect you a little bit easier. But if you're off campus, or if it's not free full text, we do recommend using this Find It at FAU button. That's the way that you get connected with our FAU resources. And if for some reason we don't subscribe to that particular journal, it will give you an option to request the article via interlibrary loan. And if you go through this button, it will pre-fill that information for you. You'll just need to create an interlibrary loan account and submit your request. Usually those requests are at no charge for you, but they do take a couple of business days, so you want to plan ahead when you are doing your literature searches in case you need to wait for any articles to come in. This was just a very brief introduction to Embase. It's a very powerful tool. The last thing I do want to say about it is, if you remember from the PubMed video, I talked about how PubMed will match your term to the best MeSH headings, which are the subject headings they use in PubMed. Embase has its own headings called MTree. So you'll notice the words that work best in PubMed may not necessarily work the best in Embase because they have different headings that they use to describe topics. I guess is the best way I could say it. But what's nice about Embase, as I showed you in the beginning, is as you start typing, it will make suggestions for you that align with their MTree headings as opposed to the MeSH headings. Okay, as always, please ask your medical librarians if you have any questions. We are happy to help you.